Good morning, everybody. Saturday morning in London, sunny weather. Packing for New York today, about to pick up Lila, and have a lovely day in London. And then I'm going off to New York, so I've got to do packing. I'm going to show you what I'm going to pack for New York. And I've got some skincare here, some new skincare I'm going to try out. And I'm going to show you what I take as my Trinny London set of essential makeup, because you never know the 8 things that I will pack in my stack. So that's all to come today. And a little bit of music from my favorite man's playlist. So I'm going to start. Good morning, everybody. I'm going to start. Oh, Supertramp. How many of you remember? A lot of things to this. I got sent some stuff. I am occasionally sent things. And I was sent via Dido, I think, in the office. And that's why I'm trying it. It's a friend of hers has started this company, skincare company. And I love something that just comes to me out the blue. It's called Ark. And there's like, it's done by age group, and it's something that I never say you should be doing, because a lot of you say to me, I'm in my 30s, what skincare routine should I be using? And I always say it depends on your skin age. It's not like a classic age. So I'm interested to see their philosophy. Anyway, I've been sent, okay, all of them. So I've got different age groups at Trinny London trying them, which I just thought, moving forward, it would be really nice. Some people in my company have very oily skin, and so I want to get some of the things that I'm sent now to be tried out by them. So Chloe is trying out the whole La Roche-Posay range for combination spotty skin. So there's Age Protect, which is for your 30s. There's Age Defend for your 30s and 40s, which Lucy is trying. And there's Age Defy, which I'm trying. So for their purposes, what they're saying, I don't necessarily agree with this, but it's all about building blocks of cellular repair, maximizing hydration, re-establishing normal hormone balance. So they're gonna do that with blackcurrant, starflower, antioxidant, goji berry, which is a great antioxidant, and vitamin C, which I would have done for someone in their 20s. But anyway, we're gonna do it. They have a pre-cleanse makeup remover, which I'm not gonna do today because I woke up without makeup on, and I'm gonna do their brightening cleanser. Now, this for me feels like it's a cream cleanser, and I'm gonna read on the bottom, but I read last night, and I think it's one you would take off with a cloth or with cotton wool. I'm not a traditional cleanser person that would take things off with a cotton wool, I have to say. So I'm going to actually get my Foreo out, even though I'm not even gonna read if it's cream cleanser. It's just my routine in which I do this. And I'm gonna just penetrate it a bit more with my Foreo, which is unfortunately running out of battery, so it's gonna keep stopping. I like to use, as many of you who know, who follow me, I probably like to use a Foreo always in my cleansing routine, whether I'm doing a balm or an oil or a gel or a cream, because it's a way for me to stimulate my skin in the morning and wake it up there, like that. Okay, I'm gonna take that off with a hot cloth. I just wanna, okay. So let me get another cloth so I can see how my skin feels after that. It does feel nice. It doesn't feel too dry. Avocado, apricot, blackcurrant, starflower, lipos, goji berries, vitamin C, so it's a brightening cleanser. Then they have what appears to be 3 products I'm going to put over. There's a Skin Perfector Firming Serum. There's a Radiance Serum, which is vitamin C. Looks oil-based, so I'm tempted. I'm just thinking which one I should put on so they don't pell. And there's Age Defy Nourishing Moisturiser. Okay, so I'm gonna start with the Firming Serum. But am I? You see, I always do vitamin C first. No, I'm gonna start with the Radiance, which is the vitamin C one, because I prefer to not put oil on water-soluble. So I'm gonna just, and this is oil-based, but not too oily, funnily enough. It's kind of actually got a nice texture. I would imagine, because I get absolutely no smell from it, that the vitamin C is below 20%. But nice to do a massage with. There, I'm sleeping at the moment and getting quite furrowed brows. There was a lady who sent me a message last night on Instagram from 3 days ago, and she just said, what can I do? Oh, I love this. This is from Spotlight, that film, if you've seen it. Fantastic film. Just to go in where you kind of might be doing this at night. You might be sleeping and having lots of deep thoughts, and every morning just to remember to kind of ease out that brow. So sometimes I also do this kind of massage, but it's a very good morning one to do, just to soften it, because once you get that double L that some people get, it's really quite difficult. You can use Botox, you can try filler, but it is difficult to go back in time on that one. So just doing that easing, so it doesn't get in the habit of forming and going around the top of your brows and just pulling that little furrowed brow apart, is something that will help. I do believe so strongly. I do lots of things. You know I do Botox, you know I do PRP, but I do every single day, I do a quick little facial massage. Saturday morning is definitely my big facial massage moment. But there, got that, there. Okay, now I'm going to do their firming serum. I always worry about a firming serum, that it's going to tighten my face, and I don't need a huge amount of firming as such. I'm far more about retexturization, but I'm gonna try it because I wanna try the whole range. I don't know what's in this yet. I will do a full review on this range. I don't also know the price point either, but I just thought I'd share with you as I'm starting it. It's a kind of product that's going in, and it's going to start to sort of not dry on my skin, but it's not, you know, it's going to leave that. And that's the ingredients inside that are sort of firming your skin. So if you do suffer from saggy jaw and things like that, firming creams, firming serums can be great. And I'm gonna end up with Age Defy, which is their nourishing moisturizer formulated for 50s onwards. See, I don't know if as a 55-year-old, I want to have something which is formulated for 50s onwards, because I just don't know if I believe that's how you could define skin. But I suppose if you want to be really generic, no. Decent smell, I feel they're quite clean ingredients. I don't feel there's any many nasties in these ingredients. Nice application. Okay. All right, that's done. Interesting, I'll let you know how I get on. I'm not gonna take it to America, but I'll continue to use it when I get back. Lots of you asked me about fine lines and crow's feet, and this is the third micro patch that I've been sent. Beauty Pie has done one, and somebody else has done one. These are meant to be brilliant. So I'm gonna try them now. Interestingly, I'm gonna try them in different locations, because even though they're for under the eye, how they work is you take off the thing, and I'm gonna put it on there, and I'm gonna press it in. And when I press it in, it feels like tiniest little needles, but like so tiny, it's not painful, okay? Tiniest little needles go in there. What that's doing is actually taking the ingredients, which I'm sure has hyaluronic and things in it, and is impregnating them into my skin and letting them go deeper, because it's using that as a vehicle to go deep. All right, so there. I'm gonna put it there. Like that. But also, I, as you know, suffer. I'm going to take a second packet, because they sent me two packets, and you leave them for 10 minutes. And I'm going to do around my lip lines, which you know I always have an issue with, and just see what it does for that, because I think that could be quite interesting. So I'm going to take, it's not what you're meant to do, but you know me, I'm never doing what you're meant to do. I'm going to do one there, like that. Really press it in. I'm so desperate to reduce it. I want to just show you up close how my lines are. You know, just like that. And I'm going to do the other side. I got these from Victoria Health. And they're called Visa Reversa. Okay, Visa Reversa. I think they're Korean. I think all these things out of this technology are Korean. So I'm just going to take off, actually, that bit there, because that's just the... I want to get just the... Actually, I'm going to cut it off. Hang on. Not always using things how they should be used. Come on. There. So I can just get half my mouth done, and I can do the same the other side. There, and then put that on there. And then really press it in. So I don't know how long you want to press it in for, but I'm just pressing. Like that. Really pressing. Wanting it to penetrate, wanting that product to go in, wanting those fine lines to disappear. There. And then I'm going to go around the top again. All right, like that. Now, I'll show you what I am taking to New York. This is what I've done, because I'm only taking 13 pots. So I've put Fortune and Strength into one pot, because I use them together a lot. That's an eye to eye. Fortune is that most universally wonderful, shimmery, goldeny, bronzy color. And Strength I use just when I want that accent of depth on my eyes and I don't want to have a strong kind of too dark a color. And then I've got Wisdom, which is my go-to neutral shade on my eyes, which just is, I can even put it on now actually, as I have this on in here. But it's just that, you know, if I want a daytime eye for my skin tone, I've got a bit of Fortune on the back of that actually. I just put that on, Wisdom. For some people this might be Faith, and for a brown skin tone, dark brown skin tone, this might be Emperor. But we have three of these kind of very neutral shades for different skin tones that just give your eye a tiny bit of emphasis, but not too much. You don't feel, oh my goodness, I'm wearing makeup. And the secret trick with Wisdom is I put a tiny bit under my eye, which I'll do when I take this off. Then I have Empress, which is my go-to brown. And it's just, it's the most glorious color to make your eyes sparkle. So if I just show you here, I'm wearing silver today, so it's going to be tricky. I won't do it today, but it's just great. You've seen it on me lots of times, so that's that. Then I have Pia and Shasha like that together, which are the lipped cheeks, because I'm going to layer things like the Numia pink. If I take, look at these together, I mean, divine. Because the lipped cheeks are quite matte, so I will wear a New York Pia, which is fantastic, and then I'll amp it up with a little bit of Mia, Pia and Mia, and it gives you this wowzer color. I'm gonna wear that with a white suit. Yes, I see it now. And then cha-cha, I do the same bit. You're doing some morning exercise, ladies. Cha-cha, which is that beautiful apricot-y color. Mia on cha-cha. Lovely, summer is coming. Summer is coming, so those are my kind of bright shades for my lip and for my cheek. And then, in my ring, because I'm going that, you know, tight on, I'm doing hand luggage for four days, I'll show you. I've got Mamma Mia, Mama, and Katya, Fresh Flush. And those are the best ones for me to have on my finger, because those are the ones that, one is cooler and one is warmer, and I can just touch up my face all day long. Then, I have got what I call my classic skincare stack. Skin stack. So at the top, I've got Nanette de Gaspé's Brilliant Moisturiser. This is, to me, better than Crème de la Mer, nearly at the end. Then I have my BFF. Sorry, I've got slippery fingers. Which is light medium. Just filled it up. And then I've got my foundation, and I've mixed it. Half is Trintron and half is Redder. And then in the other pot, I have half Redder, half Trintron. But this is how I might do something with a split pot stack soon. Then I've got Kate, which is my cheekbone, and my Sunlight. I've split those two. Then I've got Miracle Blow. Then I've got Cecily and Sasha, my duo act for when I want that bright, fabulous lip. And then I've got Lila and Talis together, which sort of makes Mama, but I need to always have Lila with it. I've got Mama there, which I don't need now because I got Mama on the ring. So that's brilliant. I could take that off. Don't need to take that with me. Let me put it in the right position here. Then I've got Lady J and Phoebe Lips Cheek, which are great. And then I've got Chloe on its own. That's a waste in a pot. That's okay. And then I've got Electra and Wigs, and that's my blushes. And then I'm going to take Talika Eyelash Conditioning Gel, because I just had beautiful lashes done by Edie. Two brushes to make eyelinery moments, and a brow in case I need to darken my brows. So that is that packing. Now, should we see how these are working? Let me just see how many minutes I meant to have kept them on for. Really would be helpful to tell me. How long? Doesn't say. Use twice weekly for best results. So I presume you can actually, no. I don't think you use them all at once, I don't know. One time use only. Doesn't weirdly say how long you keep them on for. Let me take these off now and let's see what they've done. There's a certain plumpness. I'm going to look at under my eyes now and see what that's done. There's a lot of hyaluronic in it, and the reason I know that is there's a stickiness to it. But, sorry, I'm sleeping. I think it's quite good. Gotta say, I think it's quite good. Okay, I'm gonna spend 2 seconds doing my makeup. Because I've got to go and pick up Lila. Well, I don't know what I've got to do with Lila. I'm going to put on BFF now. She is just about to do her mock GCSEs this summer. Well, not her mocks, that's next year, but she's doing, you know, that summer exams in the lower fifth. And she sort of didn't tell me there was a parent-teachers meeting this morning. She didn't remind me. She didn't know I already knew. But I think that she's a little bit wanting me to catch up with the teachers too much, so all the more. So I said to her, so many of me, I said, Lali, which teachers would you like me to see? And she said, drama, history, and English. So I said, well, maybe I should then see, no, drama, history, and textiles. So then I said, okay, maybe I should then see maths, biology, and another one. We'll see. The thing about where she's at school, she has a lot of friends. She feels incredibly happy there. And to me, and the headmistress there is very nice because she says the most important thing for those girls to leave with, because I think she presumes they'll leave with good marks, is confidence. And for me, the most important thing for Lila to leave school with is confidence. I quite liked her to have some kind of mark that she can use just for basic jobs, but yeah, that is the most important thing to me. I'm just putting on a tiny bit of Kate there, and then I'm going to do a little bit. I'm going to go straight to my ring, and today is a day of doing Mama. It's just a happy, easy colour. This is a fresh flush. Put it here and put it on my cheek. Oh dear, put it way too high up. Luckily, it's a sort of lovely, translucent, tiny bit of shimmer, so it really makes your cheeks glisten. It's a happy, well-making, it's a happy, well-making product. And then I'm just going to do a little bit more eye. And I think I'm going to mix today some moon onto my wisdom, because I've got that silver, so I quite like to just, I like moon and wisdom together, like that. And the joy of putting it on with your finger, it gives me that little bit of shimmer. And then I'll finish with some face finish, just to take away any shine where I don't want it. So here, and then under my eyes, like that, and then around my chin. That's face finish. There. And then I'm going to do some Talika Eyelash Conditioning Gel. Okay, great, I'm done. girls, I gotta go. Girls and boys, I gotta go. Have a lovely day. I might check in tomorrow morning, I'll try to, but have a glorious Saturday. Speak to you soon.